Dear students, I am Nisar Ahmad from SRM Welkin. Today we are going to discuss the topic importance of agriculture in Indian economy. Importance of agriculture in Indian economy. As we know that agriculture has got a great importance in Indian economy. Agriculture has got a great importance in Indian economy. And it is said that prosperity of agriculture is prosperity of India. If agriculture is prosperous, that means India is prosperous. If agriculture fails, that means India has failed. So agriculture has got a vital importance in the economy of our country. And this can be made clear by the following points. We will discuss the following points and we will make the clear what is the importance of how agriculture contributes towards our economy. So let us discuss. The first thing is that agriculture contributes towards GDP, gross domestic product. GDP means gross domestic product. It was in 1951, it was 51%. It was 51%. But it is declining. The share of GDP in agriculture is declining day by day. And today it is only 15.4%. And do you know why it is declining day by day? It is because of the fact that people are going towards the service sector and other sectors, towards the service sector and tertiary sector. So it is because of the fact it declines day by day. And industrial sector, the share of industrial sector in GDP is increasing. That is this time 24.77%, and service sector share 61.5%. This shows the declining trends in agriculture because people are going towards the other occupations, towards the service sector. And other thing is that the agriculture land is diminishing day by day. And colonies, industries are being established. So it is the first point that agriculture contributes towards GDP. Number second, supply of wage goods. Wage goods, for example, wheat, oil, etc. Agriculture supplies wage goods. In other words, I may say consumer's goods. That is wheat, oil, etc. So eatable items we get from agriculture. So this shows that agriculture has got a vital importance. It has got a great importance. And then thirdly, source of employment. Agriculture absorbs a good number of people. Primarily, it was 70% of our people were engaged in agriculture. And now, at least 50% of our people are engaged in agriculture. They earn their livings from agriculture. Their main occupation is agriculture. In villages, if we will tell to any person, what is your occupation? He says that my occupation is farming. So agriculture plays an important role. It provides employment to good number of people, to millions of people in our country. And as you know, that India lives in villages. India lives in villages, and the main occupation of the people of India is agriculture. So people are completely dependent upon agriculture. Then there is another point, that is source of raw materials to agro-based industry. Agro-based industries are those industries which get raw materials from agriculture. For example, we have got cotton textile industry, jute textile industry, and other industries, sugar industry. And you know, as far as cotton textile industry, it is the largest scale industry. It employs good number of people. So it is agriculture which supplies raw material to such industries, to such agro-based industries. Cotton textile, jute textile, sugar and other industries. Then there is another source of demand for industrial goods. For example, in agriculture, now agriculture has been modernized. After the Green Revolution, agriculture has been modernized. Now we are using the technical know-how in agriculture. We are making the use of tractors, land tillers, so agriculture now creates the demand for what? Now agriculture creates the demand for industrial goods. So it is one of the important. So the demand for the heavy machinery has increased, which is used in agriculture at a lower scale. Then there is another source of demand for industrial goods, demand for heavy machinery. Then there is another contribution to international trade, foreign trade. Some of the agriculture products are being exported to the other countries of the world. And our country, India, it earns foreign exchange, which is very essential for the development of a country. As we say that tea is the largest items of export. It comes from agriculture sector. So when we export the agriculture goods to the other countries of the world, we earn foreign exchange reserves, which is very essential for the economic development of our country. Then there is another contribution to international trade. Then there is another support to transport industry. Many agriculture items are being transported by the transporters. So transporters also get employed. They also get employed because they transport agriculture items from one place to another place, or we may say from one region to another region. So it is one of the advantages. It shows the importance of agriculture. Then there is another one, that is wealth of nation. As we know that India is having an abundance of agriculture land as compared to other countries of the world. So agriculture land is very, prosperity depends upon agriculture. So we are having a good number of agriculture land in our country as compared to other countries. I hope it is clear to you. In the next video, we will discuss the farming, the types of farming.